Uganda joined the rest of the world today to commemorate World Cerebral Palsy Day under the theme, Together Stronger. This theme highlights the importance of unity, collaboration, and mutual support within the cerebral palsy community and beyond. The Acting Assistant Commissioner, Special Needs Education, Sima Annette, has urged parents and caregivers to educate children with cerebral palsy instead of abandoning or hiding them in backyards. Sima also called upon schools to accept such children and help them learn.
They should take them out of the bedrooms that they are hiding them in. Because when you look at the data in Ministry of Education, you will not see as many learners or children with CP like we have seen today. So that means these learners are somewhere. They are only brought out when they realize that they are going to get something.
The Executive Director, Northwind Foundation, Abdulharim Katongole, supported the move of education to equip children with cerebral palsy with livelihood skills and give them hope, but also enable them to navigate through life.
Yes, of course, inclusive education will be the best if it is there, but where it is not there, then these children have to be skilled. And this is why I talked about the organizations using professionals. So the skills is not a must that they are got from the conventional schools. Skills can be got wherever the children are. And that's why even the majority of these partners are running centers. So in these centers, once these organizations are, can have the professionals attached to them, then skills can be got.
Similarly, Alice Tendo, a mother to Alvin, aged 20, living with cerebral palsy, says parents or caregivers should not use their children with disabilities as their source of income. These children have rights and they should be respected.
Some story, a little bit of it. There's a man in my village where I come from. This guy carries this child with disability on a wheelbarrow. He puts him in a certain junction, then he lets him stay there for a long time from morning to dawn. People come and put money in the wheelchair, in the wheelbarrow. So this boy, their source of income, it hurts a lot.
Although Alice's son, Alvin, did not go to school, she supported him to develop his talent as a songwriter, as Alvin explains.
My talent, it's my hobby to write songs. I love what I'm doing.
Alfred Wambali, a father to Ronald Kisembo, aged 5, grappling with cerebral palsy, faulted fathers who abandon their children born with a disability.
The message that I have for parents out there, most especially the fathers, fathers, you're disappointing us. When God gives you a child like Ronald, it doesn't mean that you run away and you leave the mother with a kid, because you have a habit of saying that for you in your family don't have kids like him. Ronald is also a child like other kids. For me, Alfred, I've been there since day one up to today. It's me carrying him, it's me doing everything. So fathers, please, don't run away when you have a CP kid. They're also children like others. Again, love them. And when you show them love, God will also open ways and will open doors for you.
As part of the commemoration activity, children with cerebral palsy received chairs and wheelchairs as a donation from Northwind Foundation. Cerebral palsy is due to abnormal brain development, often before birth. The symptoms include exaggerated reflexes, floppy or rigid limbs, and involuntary motions. These appear by early childhood. Long-term treatment includes physical and other therapies, drugs, and sometimes surgery. Reports compiled by Agnes Chotalingerire for the news.